We might see Samuel, but it's been so long. I don't know if he's living in the same home.
Hope so. You said so much about him.
We will see. We won't have any time to look for him if he's not, of course.
We'll see.
Are we out? Not even a drop. Come on.
Joseph?
Yes?
Can you stop, please? I'd like to walk for a bit.
No, Mary. Why would you want to walk? It's dangerous.
I'm getting a bit uncomfortable. Elizabeth actually told me it's good to walk and move when I feel up to it.
We won't have any water until I get you to town. You need your rest. Let me get you more comfortable, huh? Just...
Joseph, you don't have to be the only one walking. Plus, we're far enough away from Nazareth. Don't have to hide my condition anymore.
Mary, this blanket is stuck. There is no way that you are comfortable.
Joseph, I'd like to walk with you. Please.
I am responsible for you, Mary. For you and...
You protect us.
Yes.
I know. I know. I'll let you help me down.
All right. You can walk for a few minutes, huh? But please, not too far. You need to save your strength.
I actually do need you to help me down.
Oh, yes. Sorry. Oh. Slowly, slowly. Yes. Watch the baby. Oh. Okay. Is it okay?
Yes.
Hey.
This feels better. Thank you. Thank you for protecting me. I don't know that I've said that yet.
We have a little ways to go yet. Let's see how tonight goes and...
I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about... before. I've been meaning to say something this whole journey and I didn't and I should have. I should have months ago.
You don't have to?
Yes. Yes, I do. You could have gotten all of the bride price back from my father.
It was never about the money.
I know it wasn't. And I know it's not polite to talk about, but no one would have blamed you.
For what?
You're divorcing me. Publicly.
Mary,
you could be betrothed to someone that you don't have to hide. And people wouldn't be gossiping about you. And you could go be registered without having to drag me on this donkey for 5 minutes. Joseph. You are a brave man. And you are godly. And I should have said thank you.
God told me to.
I know he did. But you had a choice.
I don't believe that I did. But I'm glad. Either way. I wouldn't change a single thing that has happened since that dream.
Neither would I.
Oh, this all seems impossible, huh?
Yes. But remember what the messenger said to me? Nothing is impossible with God.
My messenger didn't say that. That would have been nice, huh? Are you feeling better?
A bit, yes.
Okay. Okay. To move quicker. You need water and I plan to get settled for the part where your messenger and my messenger said the same thing. Mm. And she will give birth to a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. Yes, that part. Come on.
Halt. Late night for a delivery. It was a long journey. What have you got? I'm sorry. Oh, agriculture, grain, fruit. What am I gonna find if I look in here? The best figs in the region. Didn't mention the fine goods. I'll take a look at your papers now. Everything all right? You look a little pale. Here they are. Hail season. Better not have skipped my turn.
Quit wasting time.
Right. I believe that Samuel's house is through here. I'm not sure how he will respond to your condition, but he will have water, and it will be nice to see him. Actually, I don't know if this is it. It looks so different. Maybe because there are so many people. I think if we...
Yes?
We don't have time to look for Samuel.
No. No, it'll be fine. I know you wanted to find
him. I need to get you to the inn, Mary. You need your rest. Maybe I can find a well so you can drink, and I'll take you straight to the inn. Huh?
Thank you.
Lost, traveler?
No,
longer, for I have found the way. Tychicus.
Lazarus.
It's an honor. Your fame has spread among so many of us.
You are very kind. Paul says you are brave and righteous.
It's a pleasure to serve.
There is someone very eager for your arrival. May I tell her Paul is safe and sound?
Yes.
Come in quickly.
Where there is no one.
Mary.
What did he say?
You won't believe it. He said that they are completely full. The census. Whole town is overrun. I think it's because, he knows that we aren't exactly... that I can't just give him more money like the others can. But he insisted that they were full. I was furious, but I kept my calm, like I promised.
Of course.
Told him about our situation, but that didn't make a difference either. He just said that there was nothing. Finally, his wife said that if we wanted, we could try camping in the stable. They promised us water and blankets to help, even lamb's clothes for the baby. And they promised that they would be clean. But I can go look for Samuel. If he is living in the same home, then he will have room.
I'm sorry. I slowed us down. I should have stayed on.
Oh, no, really. It's not your fault.
Joseph? We can't keep looking.
Have the bank started?
He's coming.
I'm sorry, he said there was nothing.
I know.
All right. We will make it work.
Yes. We'll make it work.
We will make it work.
Woman.
Yes, Lazarus.
sorry to wake you, but...
No, I was just resting my eyes.
Are you feeling well enough to see her?
She's here? Oh, what are you waiting for?
Shalom.
Shalom. Oh, shalom. Oh. How did they get you here?
Our former zealot had ideas and old friends to get me to Tishkas for the last leg. I was safe.
Do you need anything else?
Where is he now?
Persia, Lebanon, Armenia, all over the place.
I will just leave you to it then. Let me know if you need anything.
Thank you. I came as soon as I heard.
It's just a fever. I'll be fine. I just had something to share with you. But first, anything to report about our boys?
I don't want. Let's just talk about what you brought me here for.
I want to know, Mary. I pray for them every day. I want to know what to pray for.
They're preaching everywhere. And the church is growing. And the deaths of Big James and Nathaniel seem to have only emboldened everyone, especially Peter.
Of course.
But it is getting more difficult. It's clear they want us all dead. You can pray especially for Andrew in Greece. They say he will be arrested at any moment.
I will pray in earnest. Do you know where Luke is?
Yes, he's in Rome with Paul.
Can you reach him?
If necessary, of course. Why?
He's been gathering his record of the stories, and we spoke. But I didn't tell him everything.
There is enough wood here. I can put something together for you.
There's no time. They're coming a bit faster now.
All right, we can do this. Try to see if you can find a spot to sit on this blanket, and I'll put something together for you and clean up, huh?
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, he needs a place to sleep.
What?
When he gets here, he needs a place to lie down. You make my bed, I'll make his.
Already a mother, huh?
Rejoices in God, my Savior, for he has looked upon the humble estate of his servant.
What is that?
What?
What are you saying?
Oh, not.
Is it the Song of David? We could use one right about now.
No, sorry, it's just something to myself.
A poem you created?
Yes, but
I... When?
Several months ago.
I would love to hear it. Seeing this. Mary? Mary?
I've got you. Come sit.
Should we call for help? You've never done this before. Maybe the wife could come and help.
No, there isn't any time. We've got
this. No. Just breathing. I don't want you to see me like this.
Slow. Mary, look at me.
No, I could wait. I just go get someone.
Don't look over there, Mary. Look at me. We are not alone.
I'm so scared.
Remember what your messenger said. The first thing your messenger said. It was the same thing my messenger said to me. Remember?
Don't be afraid.
Don't be afraid.
I love you.
I love you.
Thank you for taking care of me. God gave you to me.
He has been our help. And in the shadow of his wings, we will sing for joy. A song of David. Oh. Can I hear yours now?
Not now.
Oh, I know. It is time, yes?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
It is time.
I told Luke about the journey to Bethlehem and about how we couldn't get a room at the inn. But I didn't tell him about my psalm.
Your psalm?
When I went to see my cousin Elizabeth when she was pregnant with John, she cried out when she saw me. I told Luke about this, how she was overwhelmed for the both of us. And she called me the mother of her Lord. And we were laughing and crying together. And it was all too much. And words of praise just burst out of me.
Please tell me I'm about to hear them.
You're going to write them down and deliver them to Luke. The materials are here. I trust you to get them right, and to keep it safe, and to get it to Luke. I've kept it all to myself. As you know, I like to treasure things in my heart. I was shy, and it felt personal between God and me. But I wish I would have shared it with Joseph. And people must know. These felt like God's words as much as my own. I can't explain it, but they did. And people must know. Rejoices in God my Savior. For behold, from now on, generations will call me blessed. And he who is mighty has done great things for me. And holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their throne and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy. Abraham and to his offspring forever.
It's like the song of Hannah, but even more beautiful.
Are you better? Is this comfortable?
Yes, thank you.
Are you still in pain?
Yes, but the blanket underneath is helping.
Oh, I don't know how you did that. I feel like my heart is going to explode.
Oof. Don't make me laugh. It hurts too much. He's so small.
Smaller than I expected.
I don't know what I expected, but it wasn't any of this.
No. From the beginning of it all. So, your messenger said that he would be called Holy, the Son of God. The prophecy mentions Emmanuel. Are we going to stick with Jesus?
I think we should.
Probably best, huh?
He needs to sleep.
You both do. Put him in the manger. It's a better bed than the one I made for you.
There's something else I want you to tell Luke. I want you to tell him about the swaddling cloths.
You want him to write about it?
People must know. I want to honor the help we received from the innkeeper. But I also think it's lovely that we use the same cloths they use to wrap newborn lambs. I wonder if God gave us that as a sign.
It is lovely.
And there's something else. Go get that box over there by the window. Open it. What's inside is yours. I kept them. They meant so much to me, I just couldn't leave them. And now they're yours.
Mother.
There's a rip here. From when we gave a piece to one of the shepherds to dress his wound.
Did you tell Luke about the shepherds? I love that part.
Of course.
I can't. This is too...
You can.
And you will. Let us be a reminder of where all this began. And how he was one of us for a time. Thank you. I have loved you like a daughter since I met you at the wedding. And you have done God's work.
I do miss her. And it seems like you will get to see him before I do.
This is not the end.
I will get this to Luke right away. Before anything happens to me, to any of us.
Wait. The Lord bless you. And keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and bring you peace.
And also to you.
Shalom.
Shalom.
See you, Luke.
What are you doing here? It's not safe. I could have arranged for people.
You've been recording an account of Jesus' birth, yes?
Oh, yes. I have begun collecting historical accounts.
I've just been to see Mother Mary in a secure location.
Yes. I have completed my writing of her account. Did you have something to add?
Almost every name of God uses attributes that reinforce how lofty and exalted and separate he is. El Olam. Everlasting God. Jehovah Mekodeshkan, Lord who sanctifies. Jehovah Rapha, the Lord who heals. Jehovah Nisi, the Lord is my banner. Jehovah Jireh, the Lord will provide. All true, comforting, and singular, emphasizing his untouchable, unattainable, unrivaled power. Someone so big and omnipotent that language can never fully capture his essence, any more than a graven image could. But you know what? There's something better than words or statues or names. Something the prophet Isaiah foretold. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel, God with us. It's not about the name, Emmanuel. It's about the manifestation of that name. The audacious, this really happened miracle of God taking on human skin, arriving down at our level, surrounded by straw, barn animals, manure, tears, a wooden feeding trough for a crib. Frightened parents, way. over their heads. Total strangers barging in on the whole scene, every detail so deeply human and raw. And he was willing to go through it. Even the worst that would come 33 years later, all for one reason: to be with us. It almost sounds too good to be true. And that's because if there's one thing you could say God is too much of, was a little overboard with, it's goodness and truth. What then shall we say? What of names of prophets, conquerors, secret pregnancies, and surprise guests at a birth? For we cannot but speak of what we have seen and heard, that we're not alone anymore. Emmanuel, God with us. The messages we've received mean we are not hearers only, but doers, and messengers of word, proclaiming the news to the four corners of the earth, inviting all to come and see that the word became flesh and dwelt among us. In him was the life, and the life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. And it never can, and it never will. It's not that people ought to know, people could know, people should know, but people must know. The wait is over. We're the messengers now.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing.
Repeat the sound of joy. Oh, I love that song so much. I love the finale, best finale ever. And I also love, love, love. I mean, I hope you appreciated the monologues. Tyler Thompson, one of the co-writers of The Chosen, has an extraordinary gift. And the four monologues that he wrote this year, like he wrote last year, are just one of the unique things that I think we as The Chosen can bring to the world. And when Luke Dimion delivers at the end of his monologue, "We're the messengers now." And then we go into Joy to the World. Now, think about the words of the title. It's not joy from the world. It's joy to the world. That word "to" says so much. And it also says what I'm wearing. You know, what was in the... Got to get around the mic here. People must know. People must know. We're the messengers now. Joy to the world. We intentionally closed with that, besides the fact that the song is extraordinary, but we intentionally closed with that messaging because there's such a "and now what" to this. When we know the truth, when we have the good news, when we have the story of that the creator of the universe and the savior of the world came into these humble beginnings and was in a place that manure had to be scooped out of, contrasting that with this epic, epic performance led by The Chosen's worship leader, Phil Wickham, is just such an extraordinary contrast, but yet they fit together. And so I hope that as you finish the Christmas special, that you do not, that is not the end game for you. People must know. And how do we do that? You know, there's so many ways that we can do that. But I just hope that whatever way that is for you, that you are motivated by that extraordinary message, "We're the messengers now." And that's why the title is The Messengers. They called angels messengers back then. And so you think about the fact that the messengers delivered the message to the shepherds. They delivered that first message to Mary and Joseph. The shepherds then delivered the message. Mary Magdalene in this special is delivering a message to Luke, who then did what? Delivered the message to the entire world. Because people must know. That is the message of the show and the message of the special, and I hope that it blessed you tonight. I just want to share a couple of quick things with you before we go. Got a couple updates on where we're at, and I also want to kind of cast our vision for 2022. But first of all, I just want to remind you, if you are watching this live stream Sunday night, now you might be watching it in the future, and in the future, if you're watching this live stream after Sunday night, December 12th, then some of what I say might not apply to you. For example, this People Must Know hoodie that I'm wearing and the shirts that you can see on thechosengifts.com. Colin, you can put that up along the bottom. www.thechosengifts.com. I'm not singing it this time because I'm not singing after what we just heard from those extraordinary musicians. But tonight is the last night that you can get that. So because we're going to retire it for the season. It's a seasonal item. We don't want to have so many things in the gift store that you can't even keep track of it. So this is our last night for this. And then also there's almost everything in the gift store right now is the least expensive it's going to be. We just unfortunately have to raise prices on most of our items here in the next couple of days because shipping costs and manufacturing costs and the supply chain and getting stuff over here from overseas, it's just become too much. And we have kept prices down as low as possible because we want to encourage gift giving. That's why we call it gifts and not merchandise, is we want to encourage gift giving. We want you to share the news that people must know. And all of the gift items are with that in mind. We never do a gift item that's just a promotional item or something that's just going to make you happy and no one else. The whole point of it is conversation starters. And I heard this comparison made about the fact that in the episode, you see Tychicus or Tychicus, however you want to pronounce it, and Lazarus draw that fish in the dirt. And that was a symbol that they used to identify that they were believers. And it was this kind of secret symbol. Well, in many ways, a lot of the merchandise, a lot of the gifts that you see in the store are for that very purpose. They've become in many ways an identifier. So many people say, "I'm out in public and I saw someone wearing a Chosen shirt," or "they saw me wearing it and they came up and they started talking." Or more than anything else, that phrase "come and see" that we have, I don't have it on me right now, but the "come and see" hat specifically, people will see that "come and see" hat and they go, "What do you mean? What exactly are you saying by come and see?" And Luke Dimion says it in that last monologue of the Christmas special when he talks about, we're inviting everybody to come and see that the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Oh, that's just so awesome. Love it so much. So the fact that, you know, we keep the prices as low as humanly possible because we're not trying to milk you for anything. We want you to have this as cheap as possible so that you can share it, that you can give it away as gifts. But we also use it to finance our whole company, and we finance the future episodes and seasons, and we finance things like the Christmas special. So thanks for being part of that. And one other way, a huge way that I want to tell you about, because there's a deadline coming. This is our last live stream of the year. So I have a couple, I have to share this thing with you tonight. And that is the Feeding of the 5,000. Spoiler alert, the Feeding of the 5,000 is going to be in season 3. It is the climax of season 3. It is in the finale of season 3. The Feeding of the 5,000 scene, and you can be there. Now, how do you get there? Well, if you go to Pay It Forward. So, as you know, this show is free. The show will always be free. And lest you say, well, how come some people get to go to the Feeding of the 5,000 and others don't? Or how come some people got to go to the theater and others don't? The fact is, the show will always be free. And the way that the show is free is because people buy tickets to the theater and because people pay it forward. So there are some opportunities that those who pay it forward get, and that is the Feeding of the 5,000 if you pay it forward at the $1,000 or more level. So go again, Colin, if you haven't already put up, you probably already have, but thechosen.tv/payitforward, or in the app, you can click on the pay it forward option. But you see if that level of $1,000 or more qualifies you to come to the Feeding of the 5,000. And then if you want to bring others with you, it's not quite as much. I don't know the exact number, but it's like $100 more if you want to bring your family or something like that. Explains all that. You can ask questions. If you've already qualified for the Feeding of the 5,000 because you paid it forward since the time we announced this. Now, if you paid it forward a year ago, that was a separate opportunity. This is a new opportunity. So if you're unsure, just make sure you email or click the help button. You email support@thechosen.tv, just to make sure. If you haven't heard from us, but you thought you paid it forward at the right amount, you thought you're supposed to be at the Feeding of 5,000, you can always make sure. But as of this moment, little over 6,000 people have qualified. And so because of that, we are going to cut it off at the end of the year. At the end of December, we will cut off the opportunity. Now, not everyone's going to be able to show up. Some people paid it forward without caring about whether or not they go to the Feeding of 5,000. The date, we haven't announced that yet. We don't know exactly the date yet of when we're filming it, so some people may not be able to make it. We're going to no doubt have COVID protocols that we have to follow, so there's going to be reasons why some people aren't going to be able to make it. So we are going to have more than 5,000 people who qualify, but we are cutting it off at the end of the year. So if I were you, I would go to, in fact, I am me and I have done this already, but I have paid it forward at the right amount. You go to thechosen.tv/payitforward. And if you want to be at the Feeding of the 5,000, where we will be filming the scene where Jesus multiplies the loaves and fish, and no doubt, like we did last year, we will have guests and entertainment and all that to make sure it's a great night for you or a great day for you. But now's the time to do it because we are cutting off the opportunity at the end of the month. On that note, again, make sure people must know tonight, last night, I already mentioned that, sorry. And I want to give you now our vision for 2022. Right now, I am talking to you on the set in the Salvation Army campsite property here in Texas. And Colin is going to put up some pictures and some video of what is being built. We are building a soundstage, and we are building first century sets for our permanent home. And this is something that people are going to get a chance to not only experience for season 3 for us, but for future seasons, and people will eventually be able to come visit it, and the campers here at the Salvation Army campsite will be able to get a first century biblical history, immersive, and so that is happening, and it's progressing very nicely, and we are still on track. Now, I'm not guaranteeing this, so don't shoot me if we miss it. We are still on track to hopefully begin filming sometime in March of 2022. The scripts are wrapping up as I speak, putting the finishing touches on them, and we're really excited about that. So things are still progressing. But I wanted to let you know that 2022 for us is the year of the unreached. Those four words. Oh, that's three words. Sorry. Well, no, that's four. That's five. The year of the unreached is one word. I'm really smart. Five words, the year of the unreached. That's 2022 for us. So far, you have been such an extraordinary part of this, and you found the show probably from a friend, and the bulk of the majority of viewers come from the United States. Of course, our international efforts are expanding, but so far, you outside of the United States have at times said, well, look, what about us? And we've said, look, we don't have a huge check to support the effort that it takes to get things overseas. And so we've made the show free and easily accessible overseas, but there's gifts and there's broadcast and movie theater opportunities and foreign languages. Season one is translated in over 50 languages, but we want it to be translated in hundreds of languages. We want season two to be translated in hundreds of languages. Ultimately, long-term, thousands of languages. And yes, there are thousands. And so we have been having very serious discussions with some amazing partners who want to make that happen. But 2022 is where we are not only going to be making the show and where we're not only going to be putting it towards marketing our efforts here in the States, but we are aggressively going after you overseas. We are aggressively going to be going after Generation Z and younger, those folks who might not think the show is for them, but when they watch it, they love it. We have been hearing so many extraordinary responses from people of every age and from all over the country and from all over the world that we go, all right, we got to put some gasoline on that fire. And it might not necessarily pay off like it has with you. You know, so far when we put a marketing dollar in, we tend to get $4 or $5 back because here in the States, there's abundance. But overseas and in some people groups and in some age groups, they're not going to pay it forward. But we still want them to have access to this. And so that's where you come in. That's where you're paying it forward and the purchasing of gifts and the purchasing of, like the feeding of the 5,000 opportunity and all that comes to fruition, where we are going to aggressively market and aggressively reach out to those who have so far not been reached. And I cannot wait to tell you about some of the initiatives that we're doing next year. But I wanted you to be part of that vision. I wanted you, as you think through the end of 2021 and as you look towards 2022, I want you to look forward to season three. But I also want you to look forward to your role in getting this show out to a billion people, which is the minimum of what we're trying to do. God has a number in mind. He's going to feed the 5,000 with our loaves and fish. We're not worried about that. We're not projecting anything. What we're just going to make sure is we do our part. And when I say we, I mean you and me and Daryl and the chosen team. We're going to do our part to get this in 2022 to more unreached people than ever before. And that is going to be our passion. That is our big initiative. So thank you for your part in that. And thank you for those of you who were able to see this in theaters. You've still got at least 10 more days in most theaters to do that. So check it out. If you want to see it still in theaters, if you want to go see it with a group, if you want your church to go see it, bear in mind what I just said applies to this. You are promoting and helping us spread this to the world. You are helping it become something that is going to reach the unreached. So buying those tickets here in the States makes a huge difference and is what allows us to provide this for free. But to you here tonight, who got a chance to see this tonight or sometime in the future, you weren't able to make it to the theater. You watched it from the comfort of your own home. I'm so glad you could be part of it. I'm so glad you could enjoy this. I'm so glad you could watch it with people all over the world. God bless you. Merry Christmas. Remember, it is not your job to feed the 5,000. It is only provide the loaves and fish. And I'm going to just say this. Thank you for your beautiful way to enter the Christmas season. My daughter, who was 11, was brought to tears during one of the musical performances. She felt the Spirit of the Lord for the first time that I know of by herself. No promptings from mom and dad. Discussions with her church leaders, grandparents, or peers. No one but her and God. It was a personal moment between just the two of them, and I sat quietly in awe. What an extraordinary experience to witness as a mother. It will be a memory I will cherish forever. You sparked a beautiful conversation for our hour and a half ride home. Thank you for the touching night you have given us. That's from Amber. Thank you for making this happen. God bless.
Throw me like this down in the water. Watch the mud rise up. Dress me like a lamb for the slaughter. Pour me in your cup. Should've known we'd bring trouble. And trouble gonna find you here. Trouble. I was one way when you Scraping the bottom, make my well run dry. Shake them coins, I know where you got them. Kiss me bye. I should've known we'd bring trouble. Trouble gonna find you here. Yeah, trouble. Stranger in